This is the application for the Ezviz BC2. Here we can see up at the top, this is the BC2. I have it labeled as such. If this is your first time looking at the Ezviz application, if you have more than one camera, they'll all be listed thusly. However, at the top, you can select single cameras to actually show on the Ezviz app on your main screen. Just make sure that you are either showing all or the camera you want and not wonder where your other camera went. I did that to myself, but found out afterward that I should be on all. Upper right-hand corner, there's a plus sign. That's how you add other cameras. To the left of that, you have these two elongated rectangles on top of each other. Selecting that will allow you to change your layout style. I have expanded, which shows the visual of the actual cameras. You have condensed, list, and then and sort by spaces or device type, and then you can rearrange. If I wanted to rearrange my cameras, that's how I would do that. Coming back to the BC2 here, in the upper right-hand corner there, you can see a number that indicates the amount of triggers or things that it has recorded. You could see in the lower left-hand corner, it says it's armed, and then the name of the camera right there. We also have three vertical dots in the corner. This is going to let you toggle between armed and disarmed mode just for this single camera, as well as access our device settings and our detailed page right from the overall layout. But we are going to click on the number in the upper right-hand corner just so you see what that's like. Brings us into our triggers area. There is another space for this. We'll look at that a little later. I'm going to select my device by simply clicking on it. And here we can see it's loading up and is currently sitting right over here, just off camera. Here we can see a timeline of the recorded events. These recorded events are being recorded to an SD card. Selecting our camera by touching it thusly will launch the camera and bring us into our clips area. You can see at the top there, it does want me to do the free trial. You can do the free trial of cloud storage. However, it is not necessary. Right here, we have our timeline. This is today. It's showing these are the events that happened today. And I can pinch to zoom, expand these individual clips. Because right here, there's a clip, two clips, single clip. So if I come down to that one, that is me walking past it. And notice it's playing the clip, and that's me taking down the camera where I had it. I can select live view right from there, and it will collapse the timeline. Notice if I touch the camera option up here, we get a few extra things. We get the device name, we get battery percentage, we have a share icon, as well as a settings. So if I select settings, that will bring me into the settings for the device. I have the click to expand, and we can see all of those options are still there. We're going to put it back. This is picture in picture mode. This is something unique that Ezviz cameras do. There are a couple other manufacturers that do this as well, but this will allow you to have the camera feed and not just within the Ezviz app. If I open up my browser on my phone, you can see I still have access to the Ezviz app with the browser in the background. So that is a free floating mode, and to get back, you could select that icon in the upper right, and that pulls you back into here. That is a really useful feature, especially if you're using this for surveillance. We have our play pause. Because this is a battery operated camera, you may at some point want to pause the live feed. You also have your volume control right there. Toggling that will allow you to mute any audio coming from the device to you. We also have our microphone, and doing that will allow you to speak. And you could see after tapping it, I do not have to do any extra holding to toggle it. There also is volume controls right there. If we come down, we looked at our timeline before. We have these here. One is for our cloud storage, one is for SD card. If I bring it over to the cloud, it's gonna want me to try their free trial. There are some advantages to using the cloud storage. However, you don't have to because they have the micro SD card, which is great. Under that, we have our filter. If I select filter, I can set a specific date range and time, and then the camera, after hitting okay, will bring me to that event date range so I can check things out. We talked about our clips. We've got view event clips right here. So if I wanted to see them in a non-timeline view, I can do that here. Selecting the button in the lower right-hand corner here will allow us to jump to a camera if we happen to have multiple cameras. Right now I only have the one on, so that's the only one that's showing up. From my live feed here, if I want to take a snapshot, I can come down there, press the snapshot button. If I want to record what's going on, I can select record right there. You can see there's a timer up at the top letting me know, hey, I'm recording stuff from the live feed. And I just have to tap that to stop. Now, the importance of the record feature is that, well, this is a battery powered camera, so it does hibernate itself when not in use. So unless you see motion, it might not record what's going on screen. Here we have another area to access our speaking feature. And then here we have our definition, full HD, high def, or standard. And we can cancel. I have it on high def because I wanted to have access to as much pixels as I could for the camera. And those are all of our camera controls for the BC2. But if we come up here, if I tap on share, I can share this camera with somebody. They just need to have their own Ezviz app and I would plug in their email address. But to the right of that, this is the important part. These are our settings. Up at the top, we have our name. I can change the name of this particular device. We have work mode. Right now I have it on high performance, but you have power plugged in, power save, super power saving, and configure working mode. If you come into configure, you can set up a schedule where it's in this specific mode at this specific time and then powers it down to save battery, or you can have it plugged in all the time. I like the fact that they allow you to designate how you'd like to use the device because, well, it's my device. I want to use it how I want to use it. And I appreciate the fact that they allow me to do that. Now we come down to intelligent detection. What this does is allow us to change some of the detection settings for the camera. This is a heat-based motion sensing camera. Because it is a battery camera, it requires a heat signature from the target in order to trigger. And you get all that information under the PIR infrared detection. Well, here I have human shape detection. By having that on, it will look for human targets. I can change the sensitivity by adjusting it. You can start debugging, which will allow you to walk in front of the camera to determine, is it actually picking you up? You also have the ability for detection zone. So let's say I want a zone right there. Well, there we go. I have created my detection zone and it will only detect a person in that area. I hit save if I want to keep it, or I can erase everything, so clear, or I could have specified a specific area to erase, and I'm sure I'm going to give up the changes, and we are going to go back. Coming down, we have our notifications, selecting notifications. Do I want audible notifications? Well, in my case, no, I wanted it muted, but you can change the notification audible sound to intense, soft, custom sound, or configurable, and then you can adjust how loud it is right there. This is separate from your actual phone notifications, which is pretty cool, the fact that you can have this differentiate itself from your actual device's notifications. Right under that, you can say, what do you want to get? In my case, I am receiving device messages. The interval, I have it set for 1. You can slide that all the way up to 30 minutes. So that's the cooldown between notifications. I also am accepting Ezviz app notifications. If this is toggled off, still get events in your library, but you will not receive notifications about triggered events. And then notification schedule, well, I want them all the time, but you could hypothetically set up a customized schedule allowing you to, if I select schedule, pick my days, pick my times, only send me things during those days and times. So if you don't want to receive notifications while you're in bed, that's how you could do that. And then we have offline notifications. I have that turned off because, well, if I'm not online, I don't want the phone trying to push me a notification. Audio setting coming down here, we have audio. When this is disabled, both your live view and recordings will not have audio. So you gotta make sure you turn that on. Device voice prompt, do you want to be prompted to click the little button to start talking? So make sure you come in there, turn your audio on. I haven't been capturing audio at the time of recording this app portion, so I am okay. Image settings is next. Well, here we go. Original, soft, or vivid, and it will give you a live look at your camera, allowing you to determine soft, original, vivid. So right in real time, you can determine how you'd actually like that to look. Light setting. Well, that's going to be the camera's status light. You can turn that on or off. And then here we have our battery. It's letting us know the remaining battery percentage as well as how to charge it. Good if you didn't know how to do that. Coming down to our general settings, we have our cloud play. Right now, I have the option for a free week trial, and it's going to let you know what you get for that price. All day detection, 24/7, more reliable protection, share important moments, 1 gig of Ezviz drive, 32 times playback speed. That is an important one. I really miss having that. Ezviz is one of the few manufacturers that will actually let you, if you're using their cloud service, go back and when you're rewatching your clip, fast forward through it at up to 32 speed because maybe it's a long clip and you don't want to have to slowly go through a half hour clip. Speed up to 32, you're good. Record list, if I come in here, well, here I have, again, cloud storage option and then my memory card. It's letting me know the memory card is normal. And if I select my memory card option, right there, it's letting me know the size of my memory card, and I really only have the option to reformat it. If you've got clips already saved on your SD card, you don't want to reformat it. Coming down, security settings, we have video encryption, which will encrypt your video, meaning any clips that are saved, you can't watch them outside of the actual Ezviz camera in combination with the app. That is both a plus and a minus, so do as you see fit. If you do encrypt your videos, there is a password. You can change that if you're in there. You can also set it up so that you have access via your biometrics. Network setting, you can see right there. That's how you can change your network if you wanted to. Device information, it's gonna show you time, date information, as well as QR code if you need to attach this to another app quickly, and firmware update right in there. And then we have share device. This is just another place that we can share the device. And all the way at the bottom, we can delete the device. And we're going to come back. Those were all the settings for the Ezviz B2. If this is your first time seeing the Ezviz app, I will quickly come down here and talk about some of the other things. We're on our devices page, which is what we're looking at, listing all of our devices. To the right of that is our library. This is an aggregate area where if you have multiple cameras, it will show you the saved or triggers in one location. And here we have automation. If you wanted to set up specific automations based on events happening. So Ezviz camera detects a person walking in, Ezviz light switch turns on your lights, allowing you to see what's going on. Coming back to my devices, you'll notice that there is an arm disarm button for every device that you have. So unlike the camera itself, which has a singular arm and disarm, you can arm and disarm all your devices if you wanted to. If you click on the little image of a person's head in the left-hand corner, this is going to bring you to some extra areas. My album, settings, family guest, cloud play, Ezviz drive, smart integration, new features, help center, feedback, and live chat. That is going to be for all of your devices, not just a singular device. So think of that as more of app management as opposed to selecting one of your devices and clicking on that sprocket icon. But that has been everything that we can do for the Ezviz BC2 using the Ezviz application.